Everyone, in this video I would be telling you about HTML. Actually, you can see, first of all, see that what is HTML. You know, HTML is basically hypertext markup language. It is used for making to make web pages. So moving on to the tutorial of HTML, what they say is HTML is the standard markup language for web pages. So it's used for making web pages. With HTML, you can create your own website, and of course, website is a collection of web pages. So with the help of HTML, you can make your own website. HTML is easy to learn. You will enjoy it for sure. Now, moving forward to, this is the very first example of HTML. Like there is not dog HTML. This line is to be written as it is in every HTML document, and HTML, this content is to be written in Notepad. Fine. Then this is a tag. This angular brackets within, these are the tags. So HTML tag is the very first to open and the last to be closed. We close the tag by slash HTML, and then there is a head. We close slash head. Title, then title closed. Body, within the body we write everything that comes on the web page. So H1, this is the headline. This is a paragraph. So P tag open and close. Then when I do it, try how it will look in the coding part, like in the browser and when you wrote it. So this is how it would look. This is the coding we have done in Notepad, and this is the output which you will be getting in the browser. Any browser you can have, like Google Chrome is there, Explorer is there, Firefox is there, right? So any browser you may open. So this is a heading. It will look like, why this? Because in H1 tag, H1 is the highest heading, right? And we have total 6 headings: H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. So P, this is a paragraph, so this is in the paragraph form, so that's why the next line and up in the paragraph it's written. So then moving next is the, first of all, the introduction part of HTML. So this is about all HTML. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. HTML describes the structure of a web page. HTML consists of a series of elements. HTML elements tell the browser how to display the content. HTML elements are represented by tags. HTML tag label pieces of consist like heading, paragraph, table, and so on. Browsers do not display the HTML tag but use them to render the content of the page. So this is all I've already told you. The simple document is there, and HTML tags, the very first is HTML, then that will be last one to be get close. Then there's a title tag, then we close the title. Within the head there is a title tag, within the head tag, then the body tag, and finally the HTML tag. So actually explaining all the tags here, that dog type HTML declaration defines this document is of HTML5 version. HTML element is the root element of HTML page. Head element contains meta information about the document. Title element specifies a title for the document, and body element contains the visible page content. H1 element defines a large heading, and P element defines a paragraph. So this is all, everything explained very well. So this is how you declare HTML tags, like tag name, content goes here slash tag name, and P, as I told you, in pair you have to write, this is a paragraph, and start tag is there, and the end is, end tag is there. There is a forward slash also. Fine, this is a web browser. This is how it will look like on the web browser, as I've already discussed. And this is HTML page structure. This is how the heading is there. Within the head tag there's a title tag, body, you have heading, you have paragraphs, then body close, and finally the HTML close. Only the content inside the body section, the white area above, is displayed as a browser. Yes, only the body is displayed to the browser. This is very important. Fine. This is all about the versions of HTML. You can say HTML5 is the latest version that was released in the year 2014. So going to the basics of HTML. Now, you can see that the basics also contains all those things which I already discussed, the body tags and everything. Fine, there is a heading, as I told you there till H6 there is heading. And if I come to paragraph, so this is the way paragraph is there. Now, HTML links, what are the links? Actually, links are we have anchor tag, and with that anchor tag we link other website also. Like if I this is the coding written, I just explained you this coding. This line would be in every HTML page, right? As we have discussed, because it shows that this is heading from HTML5 version. HTML tag is there, body tag is there, H2 is heading to HTML link. So this is the heading coming here because H2 tag is used. Then HTML link are defined with the tag P. So this is as it is written, and there is the anchor, A star for anchor tag, href is hyper reference. This is the website name which you want to give. This is a link. Okay, whatever website name there, when I click on this, you can see underline is there and it will open the website. Fine, this is the website of w3schools.com which is opened. So this is the hyperlink feature. Fine. HTML images, yes, you can also inculcate images in your web page. So how it is done? This is done with the help of which tag? Image tag, img tag. Fine, and there is a source file src also. Alternate text, suppose that image doesn't open, then alternative image will come, alt width and height. These are the attributes which are used, and this line would be img src. This image we want, this is the extension .jpg, means this is the image file. Or if suppose this doesn't open of some reason, then this alternative image will come. In which the width and the height of that image is this much. This is how you specify it. When I click on try it yourself, I will show you the complete output of it. This is how HTML image is there. Then HTML image are defined in the image tag, and this is the image of w3schools.jpg. So this is the image which is coming, right? Next, so we have done about the link also and the image also. Now I basically go to the color. You know, we want to color also, HTML colors I go to. Fine. Seeing the colors. Now how to put colors in our HTML page. So we already know that basic colors are red, green, blue. Fine. RGB. So this is how it works. So there are 140 standard color names, and this is how you do is heading 1 style, background color, color name like Doggle Blue, head 1, and background color tomato. This way is, when I click on this, try it yourself, it will look like you can see. So the color would come, I just 1 minute time it needs. Okay, yes, here it is. H1 is the hello world, so the color was doggy blue, so blue is there, the whole text is in blue. And the tomato color, to the whatever I've written inside in P tag, that is paragraph tag, the style background color is tomato. So this is the color we have given to our HTML page. You can see HTML can also create tables also. So we can create tables also in HTML. Now how it is done? Now this is done with the help of I just show you. Yes, this is done with the help of table tag. So defining a HTML table. So with table tag, and there is attribute is tr. Tr is for table row, th is for table header, and td is for table column, you may say cell, you can say. Fine. So how it's used in the coding form that I show you, this is how the coding is. Table style width, you're given this table width this much, 100%. Tr is table row, th table heading, so these are the column headings, first name, last name, age, table row ends, table row. These are the TD is for table, data, or cell. So this is, we have given, we have closed table row, open again table row, then table definition, you may say table data, you may say this is that, and finally the table tag is closed. So when I click on it, try it yourself, you will see how this table is formed. See, this is how it will look. This is basic HTML table, first name, last name, age, as it was TH is for table heading. Then next, in TR you get TD, table definition. So all these name in the same order: Jill Smith 50, Jill Smith 50. That way the table is created in HTML. I hope you understand HTML. There are many things, but these were the main thing to understand about HTML. And thank you, and have a nice day.